Hello. In this video, we'll cover assets and events within FMOD Studio. Let's start with assets. Assets speak for itself. They are all our raw audio files. We'll mostly use .wav or .ogg files here. We can import audio files by either drag and dropping them into this space, by right-clicking and selecting Import Assets, or by adding them to the folder in Windows Explorer and then right-clicking on the file and selecting Import within FMOD. I'll make a folder called Ambient and drag in an audio file of wind. We can search through our assets by using the search bar or filter by clicking this little arrow and selecting a filter type. A few more things about assets. You can add custom encoding settings to an asset at the bottom when clicking it, although for basic projects, you probably won't need this. You can choose to stream assets or not. By default, all assets over 10 seconds are streamed. Streaming basically means that the audio data is split in parts and loaded over time as the asset is playing. When not using streaming, the whole audio file is loaded at once. All the way on the bottom, we can also see the waveform and have some preview options to play and autoplay, which plays the assets when you click on them, looping, and compress. Compress basically lets you preview how your asset would sound after the compression that you've set up in the FMOD project. That pretty much covers the assets. Now, let's take a look at events. Think of events as CDs. You can put any audio file on it and then play it back. Every CD can have different sounds. I'll make a folder called Ambient and then make an event wind as example. We now see click to add a new sheet. Let's click and we see three options, but for now we ignore the parameter sheet. An action sheet is a way to trigger simple sounds. I personally rarely use these type of sheets, but it's good to know you have the option. You can choose to either play sounds consecutively or concurrently. I'll remove this sheet again. A timeline sheet is mostly used for music or any type of sound that needs to loop, sounds that react or change based on something in your game. I personally like to use this for almost everything, since it allows you to readjust the timing of sounds, combine sounds, etc. I find this harder to do in action sheets. You see one master audio track. Let's make a new audio track. Right-click on the master track and select Add Audio Track. We'll drag in the wind sample from the Assets tab that we added earlier and drop it on the newly made audio track. Great. So let's take a moment to think what this sound actually should do. Wind normally loops, right? Unless it's some sort of gust. So let's start with that. Above our audio track, we see a section Logic Tracks. Let's right-click here and select Add Loop Region. There's a lot of other options here, but we'll cover that in more advanced videos. So we have a blue region now that we can extend and align to our wind sound. If we play it now from the end, we can see that it loops back to the beginning. I like to rename my loop region to something like loop. Just select a region and press F2, or right-click and select Rename. Next, I'd like to take a moment to think whether the sound should be 3D or 2D. In a game perspective, wind is always present around you. It doesn't have an exact location, so 2D makes sense. If we would want to make a 3D sound, we'd go to the bottom here on our master track and click on the right-click to add post fader effects. Then select Add Effects and select FMOD Spatializer. I'll go into more depth and examples in other videos. Alright, let's take a look at the bottom right of the screen. If I think about this kind of wind sound, I think it should never be played twice or anything. It should always just be present in the game, but there shouldn't be 2x wind. Let's set the max instances to 1. This does exactly what I just said. It limits the amount of wind events, so there can only be 1. Let's set stealing to none. This means that if we try to play a second wind event, it will simply ignore it. If you select any of the other stealing options, it will stop other wind events and then play the one you're trying to trigger, or has some special conditions to which one is being eliminated. The last step is to go to the banks tab. Banks are like the CD racks for your CDs. You can make a bank to basically group events. We'll make a simple bank called Ambient. Go back to our event and right-click it, select Assign to Bank, then Browse and select the newly made Ambient Bank. And there we go. We pretty much set up our wind event in FMOD, so let's quickly cover how to actually hear this in Unreal Engine. First of all, let's go to File and press Build All Platforms. This is very important because else we don't see the events in Unreal Engine. Now open up your Unreal Engine project and let's use the most basic way of playing a sound like wind. Your Unreal Engine should say a message like FMOD Studio Banks Reloaded. Go to the top left of your screen, select this button here and press the Place Actors panel. Search for the FMOD Ambient sound and drag and drop it into your world. In the details panel, you'll see an FMOD audio section with a variable called event. Let's find and select our wind event. As you can see here below, auto activate is on. So the moment we press play, we should hear the wind in our world. Great. So there's a lot more to cover about events, but other examples are best showed in practice. I'll go deeper into everything and give concrete examples in Unreal Engine in a following video.